Namaste, everyone. This is Gil with Breathe Yoga Center. I'm here at First Landing State Park in Virginia Beach, Virginia. It's a beautiful fall day, perfect for being outside doing a little bit of yoga. Kind of just the right temperature, not too cool, but not hot. So I am in an urban area within a park. So you might hear planes overhead, you might hear voices of other people visiting the park. Still a beautiful opportunity for a yoga practice no matter where we are. There's always things happening around us, which is this lovely metaphor for our internal experience of finding center, of finding equanimity. Basically here today I just want to do a couple standing poses to really ground and root into our physical and energetic body. And it just seems fitting here in this environment to speak to nature, to speak to trees. I was just reading an article about Shinrin Yoku, which is Japanese. It's a nature therapy, or forest therapy, forest shower, I think, is what my friend Juko from California taught me. Forest bathing, basically. So being in this kind of environment is so healing. And actually studies have shown and validated that being in forests, surrounding yourself with nature, lowers stress hormones. So I'm going to start with a little bit of breathing, just a couple standing poses, and a nice real grounded few minutes that you can take for your day. So start in mountain pose. Feet can be hip width distance apart, or you can bring your big toes all the way together. Bring the shoulders up, draw them back to spread the chest, and release your shoulders down your back. Plant through your feet. You feel like you have roots descending into the surface and deeper into the earth. Big toe mounds, pinky toe mounds, inner heels, outer heels. Feel that root energy, feeling as if it's penetrating the earth to give you stability, to give you a greater grounded connection within. Grow tall through the crown of your head. Tune into the flow of your breath now, if you haven't already, so you feel the flow of your breath moving in and out through your nostrils. Do my favorite pranayama, one of my favorites, which is Brahmari pranayama, called the humming bee breath. And it basically gives you the benefit of chanting Om without actually chanting, because it creates this vibration, like the M sound of Om. So you do it on the exhale, making that humming sound. And so it relaxes the mind, it creates this vibration within the skull that can help bring balance and healing energy to the eyes, the ears, the sinuses, the throat as well. So do three rounds, makes a light audible sound. Inhale. Two more, humming on your exhale. Deep breath in. Shift your breath gradually into a light Ujjayi pranayama, the victorious breath. Makes the sound of an ocean wave coming up on the shoreline. So do this by slightly narrowing the back of your throat. And here from mountain pose, simply inhale and raise your arms up overhead. You can join your palms together, or you can keep your hands separated about shoulder width distance apart. And just feel the length and space through the spinal column, through the sides of your torso, and all the way down the legs, both the inseams and outseams of your legs. Feel again your feet grounded, strong, steady presence. So you're feeling wobbly at all, maybe bring the feet just a little bit wider apart, really focusing on that stable base. And into a nice simple side stretch as you exhale, lower your left hand down next to your left waist and reach up and over with your right arm. Press the hips slightly over towards your right side. Breathe the length into the side waist all the way down your outer leg. Inhale, rise back up to center and change. So you exhale and come over with the left hand, lower your right hand next to the right thigh. Press your hips slightly over to the left. Continue breathing, gazing, just underneath of the top arm, if that's okay, to your neck. Breathe deeply through the nose. Complete your exhalations. You're taking the time to release all the energy that sometimes gets stuck in. Reach back up. Inhale, stretch. And exhale, relax. We'll do just a little dynamic movement with Utkatasana and finish with a balancing pose. So in Utkatasana, bend your knees, lower your hips into that imaginary chair where this pose often gets called chair pose. Raise your arms up, lifting your sternum, the breastbone, up away from your navel. And at the same time, relax your shoulders down your back. Hug the legs in. If they are close enough together, where your feet are close, squeeze the legs. If not, keep the knees tracking over the ankles. So if your feet are wider, knees are wider, and I'll model that. Now on your exhales, reach your chest forward, bring your arms back like wings, palms facing down to the floor, to the earth, and draw the shoulder blades down your back. Pull the belly up and in. Inhale, raise your arms up. We'll connect this with the breath now. Exhale, torso forward, arms back. Just hover the torso over the thighs. Breathe in, arms reach, stay low with the seat. Exhale. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, come up, straighten your legs. Exhale, bring your hands down to the center of your chest. Samasthiti, equal standing pose. We'll shift from that equal standing on both feet into a balance, right into tree pose, Vrikshasana. So balancing on your left leg, raise your right leg and open the knee out to the side, placing your right foot up against your left inner thigh or below the knee is always an option, against the calf or the ankle. Bring your hands to the center of your chest. Find a still point to gaze upon. Bring your focus back to your breath. Feeling steady here. Arms can reach up. Spacious quality to your breath. Spacious quality to your body. So if you're really fighting with a lot of resistance in your balance today, see if you can soften and let it come a little bit more naturally. Exhale, bring your hands back to your heart center. Carefully aim your right knee forward as you release your right foot down. Plant the sole of the right foot. Pick up your left thigh. Raise the knee up as high as is available to you and open the leg out to the side. You might use your hands to help guide the foot into placement. Above the knee or below the knee, avoid placing it against the knee itself. Feel that contact at the midline of the body, a union at the middle. Right and left side, symbolic of polar energy, sun and moon, light and shadow. Shoulders stay soft to your belly, engage, tone in, not only from the front of the belly, but from the sides. And if you're feeling steady, raise your arms. Vrikshasana, tree pose. Just savor and enjoy the experience of being in your body, being in your breath, even if it's a little wobbly. Trees are flexible, not rigid, or they'll snap. They flow with the breeze, they flow with the elements. Aim the left knee forward, release your foot. Come back to mountain pose for a few breaths. Just take a few moments to feel how you're grounded, how your presence is more steady. Carry this level of stability with you into the remainder of your day. Thank you for joining me. Namaste.